Rainbow papaya is the premier example of genetically engineered horticulture crop.
Hi everyone! So, I'm going to discuss about the Jambu papaya in Hawaii.
Their long hot days are the perfect chance to enjoy cool, refreshing fruits and vegetables. But one popular summer time fruit is the papaya, was almost out. Jude is National Papaya Month, and great time not just to enjoy papaya but also to learn about it. Now it's only thanks to biotechnology that we're able to eat papaya.
Hawaiian-born scientists at Cornell University developed a genetically modified papaya known as the rainbow papaya, designed to be resistant to the virus.
The GMO's success in the genetically engineered rainbow papaya variety, now grown in Hawaii.
Dr. Dennis Gonzalez, the father of transgenic papaya, shared his story during the 2015 Western Plant Health Association annual meeting in Maui, Hawaii in October.
He says about 95% of commercial Hawaiian papaya crops is grown in the community of Kona, located on the Big Island. In 1970s, the dangling papaya reached Batang Ferry, transmitted by the Apids, about 20 miles away in Hilo. The papaya industry was severe and risky.
The team of scientists then worked with a public-private partnership to help them make the seed commercially available to the farmers. Within 2 years, more than a half of all the papaya grown on Hawaii was GMO. A decade later, GM papaya accounted for over 90% of papaya production.
In the years to come, a potential ring spot resistant cultivar was grown and developed and grown in greenhouses. Field trials followed. By 1995, the rainbow papaya cultivar was developed. The USDA and the Environmental Protection Agency studied the variety and approved it as seed. In 1988, 6 years after the virus entered the United States, a limited supply of breed genetically engineered papaya seeds were given to the growers in a lottery type system. Today, about 85% of Hawaiian green papaya is genetically engineered. Gonzalez says that the rainbow papaya tastes great, and it is the lowest cost Hawaiian fruit at about 25 cents each.
Gonzalez says that the rainbow papaya story is worth sharing with people, including those concerned about GMOs.
The papaya story is a way for people to find common ground in the area of biotechnology.
Gonzalez says that these technologies are powerful and can be utilized to help people, including people in the third world countries who are hungry and need assistance.
First year production costs range from $800 to $7,500 per acre. An average first year production costs $2,515 per acre. The record harvest on 2010 was 30.1 million pounds.